Iron deficiency is a common overlooked deficiency in elderly people. When I see elderly, I'm talking about 70 years and older. I'm not quite there yet, but I'll be there one day. And iron deficiency in the elderly, it can cause a whole conglomeration of physical and mental issues, which we put and we think is related to some, just aging process. And they're overlooked. And the adage is, it's just part of aging. That's what we assume. When in reality, so many times, what is the drop in cognition, what is the challenges being faced by the elderly, literally is a nutritional deficiency. And what makes this even more challenging related to iron is that the standard testing used for the first 6 decades of life to identify iron deficiency, so until you're like 60 years old, 65 years old, is not very sensitive for those who are 70 and older. And these can be your golden years. So we want to make sure you're getting the right information, right? Often we use ferritin, iron, transferrin saturation levels as our go-to biomarkers to identify iron deficiency, which are awesome. These are generally great for the younger generation, but due to chronic diseases and ferritin levels increasing as a process of just aging itself in the blood, we often overlook iron deficiency. In fact, in 50% of elderly people who actually have iron deficiency, serum ferritin levels will be high because of the presence of some other chronic illness, chronic inflammation in their body. And so they're running around with irritation, with all the problems of aging, and yet they're iron deficient, which is, slowing down healing and creating more fatigue, more cognitive issues. So this is where the transferrin receptor is super helpful. It's a protein that is found on most cell membranes, but especially those cells that require high levels of iron, like young red blood cells. And it has been found that blood levels of this transfer receptor correlate with stored iron levels. A high transferrin receptor level in the blood suggests iron deficiency. And unlike ferritin, the transferrin receptor does not go up with inflammation. So as inflammation rises, ferritin will tend to rise. This does not happen with the transferrin receptor. So it is a great test in the elderly. A 2002 study published in JAMA Internal Medicine showed that in the elderly population, using the transferrin receptor ferritin index increased the sensitivity of finding those who are elderly who are iron deficient from 16% by just looking at ferritin up to 88% compared to standard iron labs. So that's huge, right? And a TRF index, which is the transferrin receptor ferritin index, above 1.5 can accurately diagnose iron deficiency. So if you are in the 70 plus crowd and you don't like how you feel, you feel your body's underperforming, and you feel like, I'm not meeting my expectation, my mind's a little slower, my action's a little slower, my energy is not there. And talk to your primary care, ask them to run a transferrin receptor ferritin index, or TRF index test to ensure that iron deficiency is not what's holding you back, from really truly enjoying your golden years. You've been working all these years, it's time to enjoy it, right? So be sure to get that checked, TRF index. Talk to your primary care, if you're just not feeling like you feel like you should feel, and just make sure that's not part of the story behind why you're not crushing it in your post 7 years. All right, I'm Dr. Matt. If this is helpful, please like and subscribe, send it to your friends, and I'll be back next week.